estima en gloria, luz de arco iris, blancos destellos, gloriosos truenos.
Louvores, honra e glória, força e poder para sempre, ao único rei eternamente.
Holy, holy, holy is the God Almighty, who was and is to come. With all creation
I sing praise to you.
Jesus, teu nome é força, é fôlego de vida, misteriosa água viva.
An incredible moment of worship. Just that encouraging reminder that we serve such an amazing God. And I hope that that was as dear to your heart as I know it was for mine. And with that, I want to again just welcome everyone to the call. I know we still have some language things that we're juggling and working out. If you have not yet, you can select your language down below, go to language interpretation, and you should be able to find the number of languages that we support there. The last two things I would encourage you to do is to be active in our chat and to be active in the question and answer. We want to do our best to engage with you. We don't want this to be something where you're just here watching, but that together we're celebrating, we're being mobilized, we're encouraging each other because our God is truly unstoppable. And so with that, I want to just invite my brother, Martin Durham from the United Kingdom. Martin, would you mind just sharing a word with us this morning?
Thank you, Daniel. Yes, Martin Durham from London, and I direct ILI in Europe. One of the most crucial moments in church history, indeed one that affects everyone on this call, is recorded in Acts chapter 4. It's a time of the church exploding into life and thousands turning to Christ. And in Acts chapter 3, we see Peter calling to repentance those who have just witnessed the healing of a lame man. And then Peter and John are hauled before the Sanhedrin, the highest Jewish court. And Acts 4, verse 18 says this: "Then they called them in again and commanded them not to speak or teach at all in the name of Jesus." Now note here, they didn't command them to stop speaking about God or to stop healing people or to stop doing good things, but to stop speaking or teaching in the name of Jesus. You know, there is power in the name of Jesus. And at this moment, it's almost like the enemy is planting a stop sign in front of Peter and John and saying, no further, no more talk about Jesus. And, you know, the enemy still tries to do this today. Many of you will have read the ILI book, the latest book, Bold Obedience. You can download a copy of that at the ILI website. And in it, you will read of our brother, David Sagana, in Africa, who was moved by God to take training to a country where the gospel is heavily restricted so that he could equip believers to spread the gospel. And then David, as he lands at the airport with a suitcase full of ILI books and material ready to equip believers, as he goes through customs, sees a sign on the wall. And this is what the sign said: "The attempt to transfer any Christian literature is punishable by life in prison or death." And it's like in that moment, the enemy plants a stop sign in front of David and says, no further, you cannot speak or teach about Jesus here. Or in Europe, I was talking with a married couple, refugees from the Middle East, who had made that treacherous journey across the Mediterranean Sea. They were telling me about their son, Danny, 15 years old, who was confronted by a group of Islamic militants who commanded him to renounce his faith in Christ or they would kill him. And it was like in that moment, the enemy put in a stop sign in front of Danny and saying, no more talk of Jesus. Back to Peter and John before the Sanhedrin. It's a critical moment. What if they had said, okay, we won't talk about Jesus anymore? It is highly unlikely that any one of us would be on this call today. But that's not what they replied. This is what they said: judge for yourselves whether it is right in God's sight to obey you rather than God. For we cannot help speaking about what we have seen and heard. And as they utter those words, it's like in that moment, the stop sign that the enemy planted there is blown away. Our brother, David Tagana, standing at customs, and the security guard calls him over as he's looking at the scan of his suitcase. It's a tense moment. But then David is waved through and he is able to go and train hungry believers in the underground church in the name of Jesus. The stop sign is blown away. Danny, surrounded by Islamic militants, commanded to renounce his faith in Christ or die. And Danny, 15 years of age, refused to renounce his faith in Christ. And so they killed him. Whilst I was talking to his parents, they had tears and yet a radiance on their face. His mother told me that soon afterwards, after Danny's death, whilst in anguish and pain, God spoke to her so clearly in a dream. And she saw Danny in heaven with sheer delight at being in the presence of Jesus. Acts 2 verse 24 says this, but God raised Jesus from the dead, freeing him from the agony of death, because it was impossible for death to keep its hold on him. The curse of sin broken, death defeated, the grave could not stop Jesus, and it cannot stop those who are held by Jesus. The enemy's ultimate stop sign, completely, utterly, absolutely, decisively, conclusively blown away by the cross. And Danny's father told me immediately following Danny's death how faith rose up within him. And today he is reaching Muslim refugees and Islamic militants in the name of Jesus. And so back to Peter and John, as they continue speaking and teaching in the name of Jesus. And in Acts chapter 5, we read of them hauled back to the Sanhedrin. And this is what we read in verse 28. We gave you strict orders not to teach in this name, yet you have filled Jerusalem with your teaching. And then it's like the enemy is frantically trying to plant stop signs all over the place as Peter and John share the gospel. And verse 33, when they heard this, they were furious and wanted to put them to death. But those stop signs cannot stand in the face of the truth. And Gamaliel makes a profound statement. Verse 38, speaking to the gathered Sanhedrin, I advise you, leave these men alone. Let them go. For if their purpose or activity is of human origin, it will fail. But if it is from God, you will not be able to stop these men. You will only find yourselves fighting against God. And the rest, as they say, is history. A history that continues to be written. And that is why we are here today. We have an unstoppable God, and we serve him in his unstoppable mission. And despite the obstacles and challenges that we will face, God invites us, even today, to write history, to be history makers in the name of Jesus. Amen and amen. Over to you, Wes.
Martin, thank you for that powerful word and reminder that our God is unstoppable. I'm Wes Griffin, president of the International Leadership Institute, and it's my privilege now to be able to introduce you to our two vice presidents, Dr. Norval Trindaji, our vice president for training, and Michael Lansing, our vice president for global digital strategies. They're going to lead this section along with others. Norval?
Hi, Wes. Hello, everybody. Norival Trindaji here, Vice President for Training, and speaking from Carrollton, Georgia, in the United States. It's amazing. We've got people from all over the world in this call, and I would like to tell you a story. And now, you were part of that story, because that's the story of 2020, the craziest year in our lifetime. So I want to share with you about what happened last year. ILI began many years ago with a vision. Give me a second, because my outline just moved where we didn't want to. Yes, here I am. So we started 20 some years ago, and we couldn't imagine that in the year 2020, we're going to have such a different year. Now, looking back in 2020, we know we can say that God is unstoppable, because a pandemic and a host of other types of crises were not able to stop God from using the ILI team to equip leaders around the world. We serve an unstoppable God, and he makes us unstoppable. This is my favorite picture from last year. This is a month-to-month chart of what ILI did in 2020. We started the year excited, hot. 62 training events in the month of January. That's the second best January in our history. So we were set on with a goal to train, equip, to do 1,000 training events in 2020. But you know exactly what happened. Come March, pandemic, we had to stop all training. And it came down pretty much to a stop in April. At which time we said, it's going to be impossible for the global ILI team to do 1,000 events, or to even 100 events, or even 200 events. We're absolutely unsure of what to do. But again, you know what happened. Our leaders discovered Zoom and pivoted. That's the word we learned last year, pivot, turn around. And starting in Latin America and in Asia Pacific, our teams around the world started conducting online training using Zoom. And then in July, we had our first online global summit like this one. And as you can see the chart in the bottom, the blue chart, the blue line in the bottom, the numbers kept coming up and coming up. By the time of the summit, we said, you know what? It's going to be very difficult that we're going to be able to equip leaders, maybe 200, maybe 300 leaders. But you, the global ILI team, continue to respond. And by September or by October, 55 events and mainly online happened. But it didn't stop there, because in November, 58 events. In December, 64 events, meaning by December, we're back at the pace of January. So by that time, we say it's done. We didn't do 1,000 events, but actually it was an impressive number, 519 training events, being 287 were in person, 222 were online doing through Zoom. And then we had 10 hybrids, which were a mix of both. And you see the numbers of leaders that we equipped at the bottom, 17,900, almost 18,000 leaders equipped in a year when most of us spent most of our time in our houses, in lockdown, in quarantine. So that is 2020 in a nutshell for ILI. But not only that, 87 countries of the world hosted ILI training events, and we were able to touch leaders from 125 countries of the world, in line, online and in person. That is the greatest impact. In the year where everything was locked down, we touched more nations with equipping leaders for the gospel than ever in the history of ILI. And I want to celebrate that, and I want to thank you, and I want to thank all of you for doing what you did. But then we had a goal. We had a goal that we set in 2014, 100 nations where we had teams that were equipped and that were mobilizing. So we started in 2014 with 41 teams. And then 2015, 46. 2016, we went to 59. 2017, 66. 2018, we had 69 teams. 2019, we had 76. But how were we going to get to 100 in 2020? Guess what? In March, it looked impossible. By probably October, it was difficult. In the end, it was done, pretty much done. The latest count in the first quarter of 2021 is 99 teams. So we're one team away. And we're hoping that in the next few months, we will develop that one ILI team so we can complete the 100 Nations Initiative. A few months later than we expected, yet through the year of pandemic, our teams, our leaders, our coaches helped us to do that. And all of that is in the heels of something very special, of online training. And I want to pass on the baton now to Micah Lansing. Micah is our vice president for digital strategies. And Micah and his team are responsible in great part for the wonderful pivot and the success we've had last year. So Micah, it's on to you. Tell us about the strategies and the amazing things that are happening in the digital world.
Thanks, Norval. Well, throughout written history, the church has used new technology to advance the gospel and encourage the saints, whether making the Bible accessible through the printing press or being on the cutting edge of radio and television. God's people have been creative and forward-thinking as cultures adapt to new ways of communication. Just as Norval just mentioned, you've displayed the same commitment as we embraced new ways to equip leaders. When the pandemic hit in March 2020, we quickly pivoted our focus to online training, and Norval shared with you the overall training results. And I want to specifically celebrate with you about the online training results since April 1st, 2020, when we launched online training. In the last 14 months, and because of your unstoppable effort, 63 nations hosted 295 training events and equipped 9,343 people. And those people live in 115 nations. Praise God. It's just an incredible impact. Each person was equipped in the 8 core values, and they found a community online. They also had the opportunity to pray and worship with other believers around the world. And God has truly blessed our effort to engage online, and we've seen tremendous growth in connecting with people online. And I want to share just a few stats to illustrate this with you. Our website traffic grew 40%. That's 39,000 people visiting iliteam.org last year. And in just 5 months this year, we've already seen that surpassed. So we have a number of 42,000 people visiting our website and discovering the 8 core values through resources and blog posts. It's just incredible. Over 500,000 people have subscribed to our published devotionals on YouVersion in English, Spanish, Portuguese, and French combined. That's just an incredible number. And last year, over 8,000 people joined our online discipleship program and began taking self-guided courses and investing the 8 core values into their lives. One participant said this after completing a course on intimacy with God. He said, "It's been life transforming to go through this course. I feel every believer should know this." From leading through a life of intimacy with God to experiencing God's heart for people to discovering God's vision for our lives and finishing well, ILI in-person and online training through the power of the Holy Spirit has impacted lives around the world. And we know this is true, and it inspires us to find ways to facilitate even more leadership training and create tools to help ILI leaders have the resources they need. Last year, we created the first version of our registration and training management website to help you create and manage online and in-person training events. We launched it in 8 languages. We launched it in Arabic, Burmese, English, French, Portuguese, Russian, Spanish, Urdu. And we filled it with digital downloads like training PowerPoint presentations, digital copies of the training manual, and information on digital tools. And you can find it all at online.iliteam.org. We've also launched 2 new training experiences. The first is called Flight School. It's headed up by Jerry Anzi. Flight School is designed for new or existing ILI alumni who would like to learn how to effectively train and mobilize leaders online using the powerful tools that are available to us. And just as we've seen, there are hundreds of thousands of people connecting to ILI online, and you can be a part of encouraging, coaching, and training those men and women. The second training experience is our on-demand training and community. For that, I'd like to introduce Daniel Drewski to share with you about this training opportunity. And Daniel.
Hey, everyone. It is such a blessing to be here with you and to just be able to celebrate what our God is doing. As Micah noted, this season has been one of innovation and creativity as leaders on this call even and around the world have pressed forward in spite of the difficulty of the current moment. Over the past 5 months, on-demand training has introduced an exciting new means of equipping leaders. Currently, leaders from more than 40 nations have begun the leadership journey of ILI's 8 core values. They're reading the book, watching master communicators teach the sessions, and engaging with their fellow participants in conversation as they discover the impact of the core values on their life and leadership. Just like this call, on-demand training sees a global gathering of leaders investing their time, investing their availability to accelerate the spread of the gospel. As leaders connect with the ILI team online, they come looking for biblical leadership, biblical values, and a community of more than 500 leaders who have gathered to encourage, equip, and challenge each other to grow in their faith. And I think of a few recent graduates, and specifically one. She is even on this call, Annie. Annie is a Kenyan who lives currently and does ministry in Ireland. She is a dear sister in faith, Northern Ireland specifically. She's a dear sister in faith. And I was just so encouraged as she had this yearning to keep growing in her faith and growing in her leadership. She was so excited that when she graduated and celebrated, she expressed that she desired all of us to be lifelong learners, living out that proverb of iron sharpening iron. You know, even in the midst of the difficulty of this current season, let's praise God that in person, online, or on demand, God is allowing leaders to be equipped and the gospel to be spread. I'm now going to pass it over to Christina. Christina will share a little bit more of the ILI team and how the ILI team has responded to the difficulties of this season around the world. Christina?
Thank you, Daniel. I'm Christina Trindade. I'm one of the international director. And I want to just share with you that something that really happened last year, and we still have this going on. The greatest crisis last year was the global health crisis. But there was also a huge economic impact. Many people were without a way to work. Some people lost their jobs, and many still had to deal with medical bills. This situation was especially difficult for people who are day workers who rely on buying and selling each day to meet the needs of their family. The Global ILI team was sensitive to the situation and responded with overwhelming generosity, with countless acts of generosity. We documented ILI team who responded by meeting the need of hurting people and they needed in 42 nations. But we know that the compassion response was even greater than that. We're still receiving, you know, some reports from several countries and several leaders. As the world continues to deal with the pandemic, not only with the first wave, but second and third waves of COVID in many, many nations, we want to encourage everyone to meet the need of the hurting and respond with acts of compassion, you know. And now we're going to hear a testimony from Abby Bracho from Venezuela. She and her husband are the History Makes coordinator in Venezuela. And after Abby, we're going to hear from Paulo. He's ILI International Director for Asia Pacific. He will be praying for us. Abby?
Thank you so much, Christina. It's such a privilege to be here with you all this morning. My name is Abigail. I'm from Venezuela, and my husband and I serve as History Makers and National Coordinators here in Venezuela. And I wanted to share a powerful testimony with you all this morning. Some of you may know that Venezuela has been undergoing a complex humanitarian crisis during the past few years, long before the pandemic. And that has made ministry work much more complicated now with COVID. Basically, one of the biggest challenges we have is simply being able to get around because gasoline is hard to access. Less than 40% of the population in Venezuela has fixed internet access as well. So that makes online trainings and just meetings like these very tricky. So what happened is that the beginning of the year, ILI Venezuela's director and also the bishop of the Methodist Church decided to print and share ILI's discipleship material. So Carlos Pirona shared this material with many churches, with several pastors and leaders, the discipleship material, Christian to the Core. And he simply told pastors, let's go ahead and disciple people in their communities, in our neighborhoods, because whether radical lockdown is enforced or not, we can't get to the church temple. So let's disciple and preach in communities. And I'm 100% convinced that this was the Holy Spirit who orchestrated this, because 938 lives were impacted by the transformational power of the Holy Spirit in just 3 months, these past 3 months. And that is more than twice what we were able to reach in 2019 and 2020 as an ILI team. And I've heard so many wonderful stories about this. Just recently, I heard a story of three children who went to one of these Christian to the Core Bible study groups, children who were listening, who were receiving this training, and their attitudes, their language, their behavior changed so much that their parents went to the Bible study group and asked the ILI team member, the leader who was teaching, what are you doing here? We want to be a part of this. That entire family has now said yes to Jesus. They're serving Jesus. They're serving in their local communities. And stories like these, there are many that we can tell. So this just comes to show, it's proof that while COVID has paralyzed so many areas of our lives here in Venezuela, and I know in many other nations, the God's kingdom is simply unstoppable. It's unquestionably unstoppable how we are moving ahead. We are preaching. We are just lifting up this new generation, so many families. And it's so exciting. So it brings such joy to our hearts how you and I can be a part of this great story. So we praise Jesus for that. Now, I'd like to ask Paul Lo, our brother in Christ in Singapore, to lead us into a time of prayer. Paul?
Thank you. Thank you, Abby. Thank you so much. I'm Paul, and I'm the ILI Director for Asia Pacific. And it's a great honor to be here amongst you, hearing such wonderful stories from all the people around the world. I'm reminded in the hymn by Isaac Watts, the wondrous cross. And he says, love so amazing, so divine, demands my soul, my life, my all. Come, let us join our hearts in prayer. Father, we want to give you thanks for the wondrous cross of Christ that has united us all as one family and one voice, serving the same God, the same Lord, and the same Spirit. Thank you for all the powerful stories that has shaped our lives. But above all, Lord, we give you thanks for teaching us, for loving us, to be able to share this wondrous cross to the world. In Titus chapter 3, we are reminded to be ready for every good work. And the 8 core values that you've given us are the very tools ready to use for the immense work that is ahead of us as the days are dark and the road in front is difficult and treacherous for many of us. But Lord, we know that your love is sufficient, is enough for us to be able to shine your light in this dark world. So Lord, we just pray for your enablement, your empowerment, and your anointing for all our teams all around the world. We thank you. We praise you in Jesus' name. Amen. Joy.
Thank you so much, my brother Paul. And we thank the Lord for these amazing testimonies and celebrations. And for each one of you who are part of the Global team, who share similar. Hear all these praises. We're also aware of the great challenges in our world right now, especially where persecution is very intense. So in this next segment, we want to recognize these challenges or obstacles, and to bring you words of encouragement of how God is helping us overcome those obstacles, because the work of God is unstoppable. So in the next few minutes, we want you to be encouraged.
May God bless each one of us for his kingdom. Amen.
Well, thank you so much, Peter. And we praise Jesus for this wonderful promise that he is going before us and he will never leave us alone. Our next precious sister, Karima Abdul-Chala, has a story of God's faithfulness and of him never leaving, even in the midst of hardship and persecution. So Karima, will you share with us what it's like to be a believer in your part of the world?
Good morning for my brothers and sisters, and good evening. So I am Karima, I'm from Algeria in North Africa. I'm a Muslim background believer. I belong to church also, which is the largest church in North Africa's Muslim background believers. So being a Christian in this area, before the law of 2006, it was very, we could live without any problem. We could share the gospel, hold seminars and conferences in our churches. But after the establishment of this law, things began to be more difficult and started to get worse. So they prohibited, for example, the coming of pastors and preachers to share the gospel with us and encourage us. But later on, still till 5 or 6 years before, they have started to close the churches, and step by step, and after the peaceful revolution in Algeria in 2019, they have decided to close other churches, and one of these churches was ours. So it was very hard at that time. But as I loved what Pastor Peter said, that no one can stop the Church of Jesus Christ. Though the churches were closed, but we continue to preach the gospel. We praise the Lord for the social media we have. We have many people coming to Jesus Christ, not only in the Berber area, but even in the Arab areas. We praise the Lord, and no one can stop the Lord to preach his word around Algeria and North Africa.
Amen. Praise him. We praise him. Thank you. To be able to see that. I actually saw a video of a youth pastor being dragged out of a church by government officials very recently. Could you explain to us what happened there? And also just give us a couple of prayer reminders, how to help pray for you, your country, and your part of the world.
Yes, so it was a terrible moment. We were not expecting them coming at that time. We were in our weekly prayer meeting. Just before some brothers and sisters left the service room, the police came, and they have tried, they wanted to kick us out from the service room, but as we didn't want, because it's unfair, you know, so they did it with violence and an aggressive way, as the video showed. So it was a very hard time for us. It was a time of persecution, but we praise the Lord that there was nothing, I mean, no hurt or no killing or something like this. I praise the Lord for this. And thank you so much for the ILI team. Thank you for Pastor Wes, who has called us and prayed for us, Salah and I, and our family and our church. Thank you so much for your prayers and standing with us. So I have some prayer requests that the brothers and sisters stand firm in their faith and keep faith, though the churches are closed. They stand firm in their faith. The reopening of the closed churches. And thank you for praying also for the wisdom to our leaders when they face our authorities. Thank you so much. Bless you.
Thank you, Karima. Thank you for sharing that. I'm going to ask our brother Matthew Ayuba. He's our national director for Nigeria. If he will now pray. Lead us in prayer for courage. And Ayuba, we'll all pray in agreement with you as you pray.
Thank you, everyone, on this call. It's a privilege to pray the Global Summit. My name is Matthew Ayuba. I'm the country director for Nigeria ILI. Let's go to the Lord in prayer. Our gracious Lord, your word in Psalm 93 says, you reign. You are robed in majesty and guided with strength. Yes, the Lord is established. It shall never be destroyed because you are unshakable. You have hemmed us through every stormy circumstances and uncertainties of life that rocked and stunned our world. Lord, we thank you. You are indeed unstoppable. Even through the valley of the shadow of death, you walked us through and brought us out, emerging as victors. Through the pandemic, you are almighty. When physical movements were restricted and halted, you moved by the power of the Holy Spirit across the world, using your sons and daughters to bring about actualization of your kingdom purpose. Thank you for the courageous men and women you have raised, you have trained and used in ILI. Thank you for emboldening us. As we remember those who are infected and affected by the pandemic, we see you reign over and above the present situation to give us an assurance of a faithful ending and a fulfilled ending. We ask for your divine comfort on all those who are bereaved and pray your healing power of the Holy Spirit upon everyone's sick. Thank you, our Father. And everyone says, Amen.
Amen. Thank you, my brother Ayuba. Thank you. Well, we praise God for Ayuba and Karima and Peter and for other courageous men and women who are part of the global ILI team all around the world. Our God is unstoppable, and we are committed to giving our very lives to join God in his mission for the world. At ILI, God gave us a powerful vision to change history by accelerating the spread of the gospel. God also gave us a unique mission to train and mobilize leaders of leaders with the eight core values so they can lead their nations and reach them for Jesus Christ. The third and final segment today of our Global Online Summit is a focus on equipping leaders at this unprecedented time in human history. So as we go into this final segment, we're reminded of the words that Paul wrote to Timothy in 2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 2. This is the theme verse for the ministry of the International Leadership Institute. Here's what he wrote. The things you have seen and heard from me in the presence of many witnesses, entrust to faithful men and women who will then teach others also. So this is our goal. And now Wes is going to share the plan of how to mobilize more believers in order to reach that goal for Jesus. Wes?
ILI training began in the year 2001 with a single training event. And the vision that God gave was, according to 2 Timothy 2:2, that alumni would train others and that the ILI team would become a global movement and a family of men and women who are equipping leaders and spreading the gospel. And that vision we see becoming true in an increasing way, even by this summit today. Since that one training event, there are now over 8,300 training events that have been held in the last 20 years. More than 335,000 men and women have been equipped. And we just give God praise for this. Those men and women live in more than 125 nations. And we are a family of people around the world committed to fulfilling the Great Commission. You've already heard on this call many testimonies of how God is at work. We serve an unstoppable God who will give you and me the strength to also be unstoppable, and for the ILI team to be an unstoppable movement that is fulfilling the Great Commission to go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. On this call right now, there are more than 500 people who are a part of it, and they're from all over the world. Right now, what God needs more than ever are leaders, men and women who will rise up and lead faithfully during these challenging and difficult times. God has given this movement an anointing, and if you're a part of it, I know that you have experienced that anointing, and God will bless you as you move forward in your life. In this segment, we want to encourage you to mobilize you to help equip other leaders. If everyone on this webinar, this global summit, will mobilize themselves and others on their team, I believe we can see more than 500 training events between now and the end of the year as we restore in-person, online and online training and hybrid training, and even deploy the new on-demand training. Last December, during the time of COVID, the team in Sudan held an online training event. And God moved powerfully through an online training event. And from there, the team then has done 13 in-person training events in the places of the country where it is safe to do so. We've had some powerful testimonies like Brother Johannes, who was restored to his family because of the priority, the core value of family priority. And God moved powerfully, and he and his father have now been restored. Another part of the ILI team coming out of that online training event and the in-person felt inspired to apply the core value of passion for the harvest and go to an area where there was no church. And today, a church has been planted in that area because of the passion of the ILI team to be leaders who are helping to extend the gospel to places where there was no church. We also would just say that this team has made plans to continue this rhythm of online training and in-person training, and God is using that rhythm to help have a powerful impact across North Africa. So I'm sorry we couldn't get Yusuf or Habil in, because you would have loved to have met them, but technology's been a barrier, but I'm glad I can report. Now I'd like to invite Ramiro Martinez to come on the screen. Ramiro, introduce yourself and tell us what God has been doing in some places in Latin America.
Hello, everybody. Thank you, Wes. So good and so excited to be here sharing what God is doing. Greeting from Mexico. I am the ILI director for Mexico, Central America, and the Caribbean. And for all of us, this thing of COVID has not been easy, has been complicated. Let me share a little short story of one of our team leaders. His name is Jorge Escobar. He is in Honduras, and Honduras has been facing political problems and also economical problems because of the COVID. And he's trying to do his best to keep the things going, trying to do ILI training. And then in November, this hurricane came, Iota, came and passed in Honduras. And right there in his church and in his area where his home is, the whole area was flooded. So, well, we were very worried about him. But when a person is willing to have faith and to bless others, like Jorge, things can change rapidly and becoming a blessing because of one leader ready to help others. Despite of this situation, Jorge started to help others, bringing food, and ILI provides some funds to help people, to help them in their needs. But also only that, Jorge was able, right after a few weeks after things come back to normal, well, they have held two national conference training leaders right there in the midst of this situation, and four regionals out of that. And 2 weeks ago, I was helping our friend Jorge in Honduras, and it was so exciting to see people have growing and sharing the gospel with other people and ready to also start new conference and new multiplication programs because of one leader ready to have faith in God and ready to be faithful to God. So this is a powerful testimony, and I'm glad to be part of what God is doing in Latin America. May God bless you, my brothers.
Thank you, Ramiro. Powerful message. Now, Hudu is going to lead us. He'll introduce himself, and he is going to lead us in a prayer of commitment to see ourselves mobilized to equip leaders. Hudu?
Bonjour, je suis Hudu Sifondé du Bénin. Nous allons prier pour cette section. I am Odo from Benin. Let us pray. Lord, we bless you for this opportunity to serve you. We ask you to fill us with the Holy Spirit to serve you. Lord, we want to stand up as one for the great harvest. Oh Lord, let the ILI team be a mobilized global force to equip leaders and spread the gospel. Lord, allow each alumni to be a powerful instrument to equip leaders and facilitate the spread of gospel to every continent, every nation, and to the end of the earth. May we walk as one team, led by the Holy Spirit, to accomplish this great and exciting mission. Thank you. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen.
Thank you, Hudu, for just leading us in that prayer of dedication. We have celebrated together. We have encouraged one another. And now we are mobilizing one another to be faithful to the unique mission that God has given the ILI team to equip leaders around the world. Now we're moving to our last segment. We have only a few minutes left in this global summit. And it's our privilege to hear from David Thagana. David will introduce himself, and he is going to then issue a call to action. David, we turn it over to you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much, Wes. You might be inspired as I am by hearing all what God is doing around the world through ILI, changing history. And probably you are asking, what is it that I can do to keep this fire of the Holy Spirit going on? What is it that I can do to continue changing the history? And I am now inviting you to four things that you could do to keep changing history and to keep the fire going on. Number one, you can pray. And I invite you to pray, mobilize prayer among the team members in your nation. That is something all of us can do. We also invite you to join, you can join an active ILI prayer community. That is on Facebook, where people post a prayer in different languages. Consider doing that. Second thing you can do is to perform acts of compassion. You could perform acts of compassion. Look for every opportunity to serve people who are in need, and mobilize others to act for the acts of compassion. I am sure most of us are watching the news, and you are seeing the Mount Nyiragongo of Goma, which has erupted the volcano and has killed people, destroyed property, and some people cannot be traced so far. ILI alumni are always in the leading team when there is disaster and tragedies. We provide optimistic leadership that things can get better, and we become agents of change. One of our ILI alumni, and actually the coordinator for Congo, Valerie Kitwana, who is right here on this summit. If you look at the chat button, I guess he's the most active on the chat button, though he is writing so much in French. He is right there where the volcano erupted, helping people. And he is one of those who have been affected by this. We can join together and support and pray and also give towards the acts of compassion and support people like that. On the other side of Congo is Rwanda, and Augustine Muyumbi is also here on this conference. Because of the volcano, there is a crack on the road and people cannot move from one side or the other, and people are living in trauma. So perform acts of compassion. Number three that you could do is to equip leaders. Consider equipping leaders. Now is an important time to mobilize ourselves for ILI training. Will you connect to the team or team up with other people and lead an ILI training in the next 90 days? This is the 90 days challenge that we have done before, and we can do it now. Please consider teaming up with others, equipping leaders, so that we keep this fire going and we keep changing history. Number four, the fourth thing you could do is that you could give generously. You could give generously. And we want to urge you to give generously through iliteam.org/summit. Or you could even contact your national director or your international director to see how you could give to support the mission of ILI in your region. Together, we can do it by following these four calls to action. I am David Tagana, ILI Director for English Speaking, coming to you from Nairobi. Wes?
Thank you, David. And we are now coming to the conclusion of this global summit. And we want to just say that when the summit concludes, you can go to the link iliteam.org/summit. And there you will find the four calls to action, and you'll be able to see those in your language and review those. We thank everyone so much for this call, and we have some special thanks that we want to give now. And then after that, we will have four people who are going to pray in their language, so it will not be translated. You'll hear four languages. And when that's concluded, we'll be doing a final send-off, and then also just replaying that wonderful Revelation song. Joy?
Yes, thanks, Wes. And thank you to everyone on this call. We are so grateful. What a blessing it has been. And an honor just to see each other as we celebrate. We want to share thank yous. And so as we give thanks for you, as I call out your name or we talk about your area, please turn your video on so that people will be able to see you. We are so grateful for the translators, for those that have been able to use the gifts God has given them so that we can understand language, and also the chat feed managers that have been working behind the scenes. So in Spanish, we have had Miguel Ramirez and Lisa Perkins. For Portuguese, we've had Dennis Downing and Cristina Trindade. French has been translated by Leticia Anzi. Russian by Luba Kudratova. And Arabic by Kathy Sarkis. Thank you so much for helping make it possible for others to understand. We are so, so grateful for you using the gifts and abilities God has given you to help us today.
We also want to say a special thanks to those who are part of the worship team. And if you're a part of the worship team and you're in the presenters group, would you just turn your camera on briefly? We just want you, everybody, to see and to just give a wave to us. There's Norival and there's some of the others who were part of that. That was an amazing experience. There's Justin. Thank you, Justin. And then there are others that are not in this presenters group that were part of that. We say thank you to the worship team. And when this webinar ends in just a few minutes, the last thing we'll do is play that Revelation song again. Invite you to stick around for that.
And we want to also thank everyone who's helped make this summit a success. The ILI staff team has been phenomenal. Many of those have been behind the scenes, managing the chat, working on question and answer times, trying to work on those translation channels so that we all could hear and understand. And for those that have worked the technology and all the administration, we are so grateful to each one of you. Thank you also to you on the call, the alumni, as well as partners that have helped make this such a success and just exciting to see and celebrate with one another.
David Tagana gave you four calls to action. I want to remind you of those four calls to action. First of all, pray. That is ILI's first strategy for changing the world, praying for leaders and for nations specifically. The second thing we want to encourage you to do is live out Matthew 25 and perform acts of compassion. Many places of our world are still battling COVID. There's the recent volcano that has erupted. And then there's other reports around the world where acts of compassion are needed today. We challenge each of you to be God's instrument, his hands and feet, where you are, and do acts of compassion. Thirdly, we're a movement uniquely qualified to equip leaders, and invite you to join up, mobilize yourself and others in your team, and join up together. And let's equip leaders this second half of the year. As David said, and challenge you to do the 90 days challenge, make a 90 days challenge today. What will you do in the next 90 days? And then lastly, we invite you to give generously, and you can do that through the iliteam.org/summit. There'll be a link, or through your national
director or your international director for your region. So as a team, let's pray. Let's perform acts of compassion. Let's equip leaders and let's give generously. Joy?
We're going to end with praying. And our closing prayer is going to be in four different languages. And so if you'll flip your video on as you do pray in your mother tongue, we'll be happy to see you. But I'll tell you the order of these prayers and what language they will be in. First is Florence Fakua in French, followed by Pastor Rizbik from in Kyrgyz language. Adam Paul will then pray in the Urdu language, and then Kyle Phillips in English. So let's join each of them as they pray. And Florence, if you will begin.
Thank you, Joy. I am Florence Fokwa, ILI International Director for French-speaking Africa. I will pray in French from Cameroon. Seigneur, nous voulons te bénir et te rendre grâce pour ces moments magnifiques, ces moments excellents, ces moments glorieux, ces moments uniques et historiques éternels de mobilisation internationale dans le monde pour les faiseurs de disciples, pour les leaders de leaders équipés par le Saint-Esprit. Je te bénis éternel, mon Père et mon Dieu, parce que tu as rendu possible cette grande manifestation. Je prie éternel en cette saison de Pentecôte, afin que le Saint-Esprit descende sur les mouvements de ILI partout dans les nations et que l'accélération de l'expansion de l'Évangile soit encore plus grande, qu'il y ait une double mouvance, un double impact éternel. Seigneur, merci pour les vies transformées. Merci éternel, mon Père, de consolider les équipes ILI. Merci, Seigneur, de nous permettre de vaincre le COVID et de continuer d'accélérer l'expansion de l'Évangile dans le monde. Et merci, notre Père et notre Dieu, parce que nous sommes instoppables. Que ton nom soit béni et que ton nom soit glorifié, alors que nous continuons d'être fidèles à ton appel de faire de toutes les nations des disciples. Au nom de Jésus-Christ, nous avons prié. Amen.
Büt havan, büt yer seni danktayt. Rahmat Kudayım sen Orta Aziyanı turguzganın üçün. Orta Aziyaga güçtü güçtü kızmaçlarında jaratkandığın üçün. Sen en bizdin jaratuçu, tarıktı jaratuçu, bizdin Kudayımızsın. Sağa rahmat, sağa dank, sağa alkış adekvayım. Dağı dili olsa tarıktı jaratuçu adamları turguza görç adekvayım. Senin jürügünde düşüngön. Senin şunçalık düşümünde düşüngön. Jana şun deli bütün dünyaya şeyin bargan kızmaçlarında jarata görç ata. Sağa rahmat, senin sözün üçün, senin ıyık ruhun üçün, senin gücün üçün, bizde yetiştirdiğin üçün sağa çoğu razıcılığınızı bildirgiz gelet atık vayım. Senin jüreğinde düşüngün, senin şunça alıp akılınızı düşüngün adamlarda, kızmatçılarında jarata görç atık vayım. Senin sözünde şu tayman bastan, güç minen atık vayım. Toz kolduklarına karabastan, senin sözünde yetkizgenge batanda öyle görç atasuran ağız. Sen danktalı otatıklı, bizden en güçtü, kudretli güçtü kudayısın. Sen bizde şu dünyada güvölör kılgansın. Hoşunluktan bütün dünyada senin sözünü tarkatkanga, senin suyunu tarkatkanga batanları görçü. Bugün kündeki kıyınçılıklar, bizge tutkolduk bal olbayt, senin suyun. Sen bizge şunçalık asmanından ıyıkırıktın, otun cağdıra gör atıklayım. Hoşul tutkolduklardın bağırdığın, kıyınçılıklardın bağırdığın atıklayım. Senin hoşul bizge yörgün otun örtüp çevirsegen atıklayım. Sağa rahmat, İsa'nın ısmını ansıran ağız.
Amen.
Lord, the nations are crying. Come, let us go to the mountain of the Lord, to the house of the God of Jacob, that he may teach us his ways, that we may walk in his paths. Lord, your burden is for the whole world. Lord, for every soul. Lord, you have called us, you have equipped us, and you have called us out. Lord, especially in these days of great trauma. Lord, you are unstoppable. And because you are within us by your Spirit, we are unstoppable. Lord, pour out your Holy Spirit. Pour out your Holy Spirit, Lord. Let us hear your voice. Lord, move in us that we might move for your glory. Lord, your prophets have declared that your glory will cover the earth the way the waters cover the sea. Lord, may it be done in our days. Lord, may we behold your wonder. Truly, truly, you are unstoppable. Work for your glory. Amen.
Amen. خدا قدوس بہربر کے خالق اور مالک ہمارے پروردگار ہم سے بے پناہ محبت کرنے والے خدا قدوس آج کی شام اس برادران رفاقت میں آپ کے تیری حضوری میں تیری شکر گزاری کرتے ہیں عظیم پاک خداوند آئی ایل آئی کے لیے ساری ٹیم کے لیے خداوند جو منصوبہ تُنے ہمیں سونپا ہے عظیم خداوند ہم دعا کرتے ہیں کہ ہمیں کوئی ہلانے والا نہ ہو ہم انشیکبل ہو یسوع مسیح کے نام سے اور تیرا وہ وعدہ ہمارے ساتھ ہو کہ تو دنیا کی آخر تک ہمیشہ سے ہمیشہ تک ہمارے ساتھ ہے خداوند اس رویا کے لیے ہمارے دل خوشی سے بھرے ہیں اور خداوند ساری رفاقت کے لیے جتنے ممالک سے بھی خداوند اس سمٹ میں لوگ موجود ہیں ان کے لیے تیری برکت کو مانگتا ہوں تیری قوت کو مانگتا ہوں اور خداوند دعا کرتا ہوں یہ رویا ابد سے ابد تک ہمارے ساتھ رہے اور ہم جب تک تو آنا جائے ایسے ہی برادرانہ محبت میں تیرے ساتھ رہیں خداوند کیلیفورنیا کے لیے جتنے ممالک بھی اس سمٹ میں ایڈ ہیں یسوع مسیح کے نام سے بدر ویسٹ کے لیے جوائے کے لیے اور جتنے ممالک اس وقت سمٹ میں ایڈ ہیں یسوع مسیح کے نام سے برکت چاہتا ہوں خداوند دعا کرتا ہوں آئی ایل آئی ایکسپینڈ ہو اور خداوند یہ رویا دنیا کی انتہا تک پہنچے اور تیرا کلام فرماتا ہے کہ جب تم قوت پاؤ گے تم میرے گواہ ٹھہرو گے یسوع مسیح کے نام سے خداوند سارے ماحول کو تیرے سپورٹ کرتے ہیں تو شروع سے آخر تک ہمارے ساتھ رہا اور یہی محبت اب تک ہمارے ساتھ رہے یسوع کے نام سے آمین
آمین Thank you all my brothers and sisters and thank everyone let's ask the presenters to turn on their video so we can all see each other wave and say goodbye before we hear the great revelation song again it's been such a blessing to be together
Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord from Singapore to San Francisco and all parts in between.
Blessings, Amen. Everybody. Such Amen. A joy
Thank
to be
everyone
together with you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
It's back.
Hallelujah.
Blessings.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Thank you, translators. Hallelujah. Praise the
Praise
Lord.
Praise God. Thank you for the Daniels. It's the King.
Thank you, Leticia.
Wonderful. Wonderful. Oh, yes.
Thank you, Dennis. Asante sana.
That is praise the Lord. Great job, everyone.
Au revoir, félicitations, bon travail. Great job, everyone.
Thank you, Florence.
Excellent.
What an amazing summit.
The worship song. So we're going to play the worship song again now, just so you can just be ministered to. And this will be our closing, the Revelation song.